I think this one has to be it. Yep, it is, it is, it is. Where is he? Where is he? He's over there. All right. Now we have to stay on the move. We cannot proof this cave. Is there only one? That, as I love to call him as a child. Oh, is there one over there? Yeah, he is, but that one's stationary. That is a Gatling Groink. As I called him as a child, though. Where'd he go? Where'd he go? That's a turkey. Where'd he go? What? Hello? Did he walk off the ledge? Where'd he go? Did he die? I think he died, guys and gals. This is the enemy that I dread more than the bull bear. Sees enemy, runs for life, enemy decides to quit, and jumps off cliff and dies. What a stunning conclusion to a brilliant hero story. Alright, let's just proof the stupid cave. So the Gatling Groink, this one's stationary, is a weird enemy. Normally just wanders around, although there is a different variant that will remain stationary, and it will shoot mortars at me. Those mortars do insta-kill Pikmin, or they can. I think there is a chance if they're far enough away from the explosion that they will live, but otherwise, for all intents and purposes, they're an insta-kill move. The windshield on its front protects it from Pikmin tosses. Even purple Pikmin will not do anything against it, so I really have to get behind it and then kill it that way. Now, after it dies, there is something special about it as well, which earns it the name Turkey in my eyes. So I'll need yellows. I think that this is all I really need. I do want to kill this Careening Dorigi bug. Come on, kill him. Really? Just threw him all off. Oh boy. So like I said, this is a different variant, even though they're not, like in the Piklopedia, they're not called different variants. It still is, because in the game's code, it is coded differently. Which is odd, but it is. I need more Pikmin. Let me go grab some... Actually, just grab some purples. If I can hit it, it'll instantly be forced to the ground, so... I just have to be careful that... Oi! That worked! That definitely worked. And goodbye. The running throw for the win. The running throw. Alright, let's go kill him. He can't be brought to the ground. Now, he will shake Pikmin off. Oh, he lived. He lived, okay. And he's dead. Alright. So, yeah. When he dies, he's in this pose, and he looks like a turkey. But this is the one enemy that you have to take to your base. Well, actually, one of two. Because just like the bull bear, which we have not encountered yet, but I've been kind of hyping it up. This enemy will actually come back to life. So we basically just knocked it unconscious. Also, when it dies, it's in this turkey pose, which is why I call it turkey. Also, it gobbles like a turkey. So that's what earned it the name in my book. It's actually... It's also coming back to life rather quickly. Alright, what's that way? Besides what was supposed to be another Gatling Groink. Just red Pikmin, I think. And them, okay. I guess I have them too. I don't think there will be any traps here. Simply because there are two Gatling Groinks, or there are supposed to be, even though one jumped off a cliff. And there are so many bomb rocks around, I'm not feeling it. Maybe here. Actually, here there's definitely one. Maybe? Let's not get them stuck in the nectar. No, this one's fine. Huh. Well, that's nice. Are there no treasures over here? Is this just empty? No, there is one. Okay, so this area has a use. It's also used to lure the other groink over here. That sounds kind of bad. No, oh, there's one. There's a treasure or a trap treasure enemy. Bad monster. Bad man. What is this? A preceding person system. Indomitable CPU. Come on. Make sure there are no enemies. Okay, we're good. Is that really all they live for? They live their entire lives being like, one day I'm gonna explode and kill somebody. And then they do. That actually kind of rings true to life, sadly. On that note, let's leave this cave. I think the next floor is the final one. In which case, we're doing rather well, and also in which case I was wrong about my whole two rest areas on this area in this cave. I may be thinking of a different cave, or I don't know what I'm thinking of, but I thought it was this one. Maybe it still is. That's possible. There could be another rest area. If so, it would be next or nothing, because I'm pretty sure this area doesn't have more than 10 sublevels, or this cave doesn't have more than 10 sublevels. Oh, we missed a treasure. Okay. Some red electrical tape. I knew it. So, I guess the trigger for the... Also, this is the second trap that's been interrupted by a treasure. I think how treasures work in this is it's not necessarily... Well, actually, no, I think it's both. I think... Yeah, it can outrun it. Okay. So, I don't have to whistle anybody. Hey, buddy. Nice. So, yeah, there are different triggers for when a trap should be set off. Either carrying or digging up or walking with a... Walking just having a captain or walking with a Pikmin or having at least one Pikmin. There may be also other triggers for traps based on how many Pikmin are in the group. That one I find a little bit less likely, but it's still possible that there's a trigger for that. Furious adhesive, because it's red. And that's it. Whew, next floor. Maybe it's the last, maybe it's not. We'll find out. If it is, I am a bit scared, actually. Do you remember in Breath of the Wild when I faced the Incredibles monster? As the game freezes. Nope, okay, this is not it. There is a right. I was right! My memory was correct. So never mind, that whole little that little vague intro I gave doesn't matter. Also, I'm lagging again. So let me go clear off some space on my computer again. Alright, this time I cleared off some files I just had sitting around. I wasn't specific, because I didn't actually remember what files I took out. But they were some. Alright, so it's Red Pikmin's turn. I'm so glad I was right about this, actually. Also, they gave us a candy pop bud to multiply Pikmin, but I don't need it. I haven't lost any, because this is the new and improved reformed pal, the new paladin. Are there no candy pop buds over here? Oh, there's one over there. Okay. I actually want to break all of these eggs, even if I don't need the nectar, because they could contain, a spray. And if it had a spicy spray in it, I'd be a happy camper. All right, let's throw some Pikmin in here. I don't need the candy pop buds, the other ones, because I am good at this game. Let's grab Louie to pluck all the Pikmin. And pluck some new purples. I think that means we're above 50, I think, of purples. I'm not actually certain, but we still have a lot. Okay, you guys get flowered. Neat. We have a lot of Pikmin. We have a lot of purples. How many do we have in the group? We have 35, so this means we'll have 40 purples in our squad. That's nice. Alright, let's flower these. Flower the rest of them. Get them in a small group and rush them! Come on. One missed. That's fine, there's more nectar for them. Am I missing an egg? No, I'm not. It's also interesting that they give a geyser, and that's partially because they do expect, I think they expect that I would be farming colored Pikmin here. All right, nice. And so if I came for just the purples and I didn't want to go to the final floor, then I can. Or if my numbers are too low to go to the final floor. Although I don't know why they would do that, considering they gave me these. No, I don't want to go into the geyser. Let's go over to the cave and then go into the final floor. Where is the cave? There it is. With my 40 purples and 4 bitter sprays, which I need to remember to use. I got them so I could use them. All right. Let's go to the final floor, presumably. Unless it's not, in which case I'll eat my words. So do you remember in Breath of the Wild when I faced the Incredibles monster? Well, we're about to face one again. This is... Where is it? Oh. That is a Guardi. I mean, manet legs. This is definitely not Breath of the Wild, even though it's like the same thing. Ancient technology. Where is a barrier? I need cover. You might be asking, why do you need cover, pal? This is not a first-person shooter. This is not Zelda. This is not Overwatch, which is a first-person shooter. Why do you need cover? Well, I'll show you. Let's leave one captain with captain here. This is a Dweevil, kind of. He's a very special Dweevil. Going to take yellows and purples. Boy. Olimar, actually, you take everyone. Where is the geyser? I need the safest place to put these whites that won't get in anyone's way. Way over there, okay. So I'll put them over there, out of sight, hopefully out of mind, because this thing definitely has a mind. That is the manet legs. And unlike other Dweevils, this one has a unique form. It's metallic, it has smokestacks on it. I need a fast-moving Pikmin, there we go. And this thing moves quickly. You ready for the manet legs? Neither am I. Throw a Pikmin on it. The manet legs moves very quickly, and you actually need to take cover. I need to take cover here because it has a gun. Don't move towards the don't move towards Olimar, please. Okay, it's moving this way. It moves very quickly, as you can see, and I need to be very careful for when it tries to scan the area. Don't scan. Oh, it's gonna do it. It's gonna do it. Oh, maybe not. I wanna wait until after it starts shooting. After the firearms start coming out, then I want to attack it. Because it actually has a gun. One more time. If it doesn't do it then I know it's probably safe to attack. Oh, there it is. There it is. There it is. Oh, no. No. Oh, whew. Good job. Yeah, it can shoot Pikmin, which makes it much scarier than any other Dweevil. Come on, don't stand up on a high area. Get down. No! Run! Run! I lost a purple. That's the first purple I've lost. Okay, that's my cue. I probably should be trying yellows, but... Get out of the way. The gun again. Oh, I'm right next to it. This is so dangerous. Get right up against that. Hug that wall like something you hug. Nope, no. Come on, Pikmin. I have not heard it yet. Oh, wait. Dodge, Pikmin, dodge. I have to be careful here because I can't, there isn't a specific direction I can use to be able to make all the Pikmin dodge. Come on. There. Come on. That's my cue. Nope. There. I froze it. Get on it. Nope, no, no, no. Then run. Then run. Then run. Then run. Oh, this thing's hard. No, purple. Oh boy, run. I can't take cover. Oh, Louie took a hit. Louie took a hit. I may have to freeze it again. Get over here, get over here, get over here. Got him. Nice. Nice. Freeze it. I won't attack it while it's frozen. I'm actually just going to run because I need the cover and I don't want Louie to take another hit. I don't actually think he has another hit in him, which means things could get disastrous if, in fact, dismiss and go back. Nice. For a second, I thought he jumped. I didn't see him at first. Okay, come on. Good. Got some Pikmin on him. Nice, and that's my cue to get more. Nope. Freeze him and run. I think I just need to kill it, hit him one more time. One more time. Honestly, actually, I could have killed him there. I guess I, no. One downside to killing enemies while they're frozen is that you don't get to see their super sweet death animation. And I'm pretty sure this guy has a nice one. So, and it can feel a little bit cheap. All right, Manit Legs, come on. Try to wrench him off. Come on. Nope, freeze him. Okay, I'm going to have to kill him. Actually, no. I don't have to. I don't have to. I can run away. Run away. Ugh. Get in cover. I used up all my sprays, but that's what they're there for. They're there to save Pikmin and so I can see his super sweet death animation. Come on, buddy. He's steaming. Get on him. Get on him. Get on him. Kill him. No. I don't have a spray. No. This is not good. This is not good. Oh, I lost many Pikmin there. But I have to kill him now. Get on him. Yes. That was worth it. That was worth the battle. I lost some purple Pikmin there, but honestly, I'm pretty satisfied with how that turned out. That mechanized monstrosity is no longer functional. An insect and a machine forming a symbiotic relationship. Life forms here are beyond odd. Initiating area scan. Glass sphere detected. Whew. How many purples do I have? Let's round them up and then count them. 31. I lost 4. That's not bad, actually. I mean, I would like to lose none, but I only lost 4. And then the rest of the Pikmin I lost were just yellows. That was a hard battle. And you can see why I dread that enemy. It moves so quickly. It's unpredictable. Most of the first part of the battle was just spent guessing what he was going to do and trying to figure out a pattern. The rest was just spent trying to dodge him, since it's, unless I have a troop of all yellows, then it's kind of difficult to get a good damage in on him. And the reason why I took all purples there and then some yellows was actually a suggestion of the book of the Prima Guide. It says to throw purples at it. I do not suggest that strategy, but I was trying it out for the first time. Stellar orb and some Pikmin freaking out in the background. If I combine this glass sphere with the synthetic sun, I have been secretly you've been developing a synthetic sun? In secret? That could have killed us all. You dumb rust bucket. Processing complete. I have manufactured a solar system. He just made an entire solar system out of a light bulb. Wow, okay. Edison would be proud. The artificial sunlight it emanates will brighten underground areas. Cool. And so now, this is actually talking about that one cave with that one upgrade that I don't like because it makes things a little bit more inconvenient. This is also kind of inconvenient. Not really because it's light, but because after getting this upgrade, the game kind of loses a sense of mystery in the caves. They're under a spotlight. Honestly, if it were my choice, there would be an option, or there would be an area in the options menu to turn on and off specific upgrades. That would have been nice, and this would have been one that I would turn off. But we have it now. Where I turned myself around. Let's leave the cave. Not once and for all, because I'm probably going to be returning here to farm up Pikmin, but for a while, let's leave the cave. This cave was also really difficult, and it threw some things at us that we had encountered thus far, but not in near as much frequency. Which is actually a nice pun for the cave, because it was based on electronics. But with all of the bomb traps that there were, and some of them were quite devious, proofing caves has never been more important. But we lost 14 Pikmin, which is unfortunate, but not necessarily avoidable. Let's save and go back above ground where we can finish out the rest of the day. Valley of Repose. It's good to be back, and we have a substantial amount of the day left to 80% of the debt recovered. Ugh, so sad. Alright, let's put the remainder of my purples back in the ship. Now I have 41 purples. Or is that 41? No. Is that 41? Yeah, it's 41. Thought I said 55 there, but oh, that was the count of how many Pikmin are out and about. And then whites, which we did not lose any of. Which means we now have 48. And now what we need... Not sure how I'm going to handle this. There are two ways that I can handle it, so I guess I will take out half and half. There is a certain enemy that I think we have time to try and reach. The Fiery Bulblax is a little bit difficult to try and get to because it's across water, but it's also wreathed in flame. And there are two ways to defeat it, one of which is to lure it into the water and then kill it with blue Pikmin while it is in the water and effectively doused. And the other way, did the eggs respawn? Actually, no. Okay, so I guess I'll have to deal with some leaf Pikmin. The other way is to leapfrog the red Pikmin across those islands, which you probably haven't seen, but there are some islands next to it, and I can leapfrog them across, and if I do that, then stuff happens. Then I can get to it. Come on, red Pikmin, you're really slow. There's no reason for you to be this slow. And actually, if we do that today, then there's only one thing left to do in this area, and that is go to the cave over there, which we haven't discovered yet, but if I have time, I'll discover it before we leave. Come on. These Pikmin are very slow. I'm going to try the blue Pikmin plan first, mainly because I have to clear the area out anyway of the water dumples. So I'll try the blues first. If that doesn't work, then I'll opt for the reds. Alright, blues. Get ready. Also, I didn't realize that getting out of that cave completely heals you. I forgot about that. Kill him! Kill him! Nice. Alright, no casualties. I got stuck in the water dumple there. Water dumple is the word that I said back in Skyward. I've been referencing Skyward Sword a lot lately. But I remember I said it back in Skyward Sword, and don't say that word slowly because you can quickly realize what it actually sounds like. Alright, I'm immune to fire. Punch him. Come on, buddy. If I can get him into the water here. Nope. Yep, that's not quite good enough. I can get him over here, though, because that's probably a little bit closer to his radius. Oh, boy. Come on, kill him! Oh, that's not gonna work. That's not gonna work. Yeah. I lost 8. That guy's nasty. You really have to just get behind him and kill him from there. Or just use a spray. That's another way I can do it. If I had any sprays left, then I could throw them into... Oh, that's so hard, though. Actually, wait. I have a strategy. Come here. As I... Let's not lose everyone. Did I lose everyone? No, I'm good. No, stay. Stay in the middle of the island. Okay. Run here. This way. This is not conducive. I shouldn't have led this big of a party in there. Okay. Now run this way. Come on. You guys can make it. You're good swimmers. Good job. Oh, I thought I actually lost one. Oh, well, this is not good. He didn't get to sleep. There's no escaping this. Throw him on him. Kill him. Keep throwing him. Kill him. Come here. Yes. All right, now what I can do, switch over to Louie. Louie, you grab the blues. I have just enough. Now, there actually doesn't have to be a convenient path back to base. Like, I don't have to have the ability for Olimar. Oh, hello. You guys, I'd rather not drown or die. I don't have to, like, the game doesn't look at it, if I can speak. The game doesn't look at the game, or at the pathing, and say, oh, well, Olimar can't reasonably reach the base without running Red Pikmin into the water. So, they're all going to die. It doesn't look at that. It looks at how many Pikmin are in party. So I can just leave Olimar and the rest of his Pikmin right here, and then Louie can go back to base, and things will be fine. So I can do that. I got all of the above ground treasures, I think. Oh, no, I did not. There's a bear. Okay. I will need yellows. I think I need yellows to get the bear, which I don't think I have time to do that today. But the next time I come back to the Valley of Repose, which I don't think will be soon, I can go get the bear. So that bear can be gotten. Also, wait, is this... I thought this watch was running, and it kind of freaked me out because it's running. But no, it's kind of running? It's going back and forth. Which could be. This could be an effect of radiation, judging by my theory, which I talked about earlier. I don't know why I'm using my Flint Craggly voice, but it definitely works for the situation. Alright. I love that voice. I'm kind of sad that the segment didn't last longer in Super Paper Mario, so I could use the voice more. Alright, never mind. I was gonna say, I can show off an Easter egg, but no, there's no time, and I need... Olimar can't be out there with a bunch of Pikmin for me to show off the Easter egg, so I'll wait for another day. This is also, just like the Bulblax Kingdom Day, this is probably also one of the more productive days, and this is running. Slightly. It's one of those things where it's running out of battery and it just goes back and forth, which watches do, so... Radiation, guys! Radiation. Alright, make sure there are no free Pikmin. There are none! Alright, well, let's put the blues away. And I'm going to rekindle a tradition which I did as a child. Whenever there was time left, and I had extra time in a day, make sure once again... Are there really 60 reds over there? Wait. That's weird to me. Yeah, okay, that's fine. Whenever I was a child, what I would do is when there's time left in the day, instead of just ending the day from the menu, which I can, I would run. I would just run. I would see how far I could get. I would visit old areas like this, which really, this is where Louie landed, by the way. There are really no reasons to return here after I've already been there. But I like returning, and yeah, this is a good jog. And we get the music! I believe this music only happens if I reach a certain amount of Pokos earned in a day. Future Pal, correct me on this, as always. But it's one I didn't hear much as a child, because after beating the game, after getting stumped on the final boss and not beating the game, I just farm Pikmin, and so I would hear the normal ending every night. Alright, let's see how much money we got today, because it's It's an insane number. We're also almost there. We're almost ready to complete the debt. So I should check to see whether or not the next cave I enter will complete the debt, or if I can get one more in. Wow, this is... Wow, that's a lot of money. That's a crazy amount of money. We got above ground treasures, we got below ground treasures. We beat a very difficult boss. We ran from a Gatling Groink that just killed itself. We got some turkey. We lost some red Pikmin, we lost some yellow Pikmin. Actually, total, we only lost 8. We only lost 8 Pikmin today. Well, that's good. Both the whites and the purples are looking up. I still need to get 59 purples because I need 100 purples for 100% completion. So I'll be doing that someday soon. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Oh wait, there's one more slide. Olimar, you'll soon be promoted to manager. Only a small bit of debt remains. You've done great, as have I. No one dodges debt collectors like I do. I'm a pro. Ho ho. I don't know why I'm Mario without an accent. All right, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed today in any capacity, please click like. If you didn't, then drop a comment telling me how I can make tomorrow so that you would like it. Speaking of tomorrow, I think I'm going to be returning to Perplexing Pool. Either to complete a cave, or do some more above ground treasures, or I don't know, we're close enough to the end of the debt, I may possibly be completing it tomorrow. If not, then it's only a matter of a couple of days before I do. So, I release new episodes of Pikmin 2 every Tuesday and Thursday. I'm also playing through The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild right now, and episodes of that come out every Monday and Wednesday. So, I'll join you tomorrow, or on an episode of Breath of the Wild. See you guys then. I may have to make a crash landing in the water. In fact, I don't have to. Let's do it anyway. Or... do that. Oh, I can do that if I... No! Oh, man. I drowned. By getting every treasure in both the Citadel of Spiders and the cave that I mentioned earlier, I will have 9,970 Pokos.